So it's a little bit late. Halloween's kind of over. I apologize, but I'm now in costume. I don't really have to do much of anything. This is a robe and a sash. And guess who I'm supposed to be? Stereotypical white Jesus. Ha! I actually had a crown of thorns, but it catches on the hair so much. No Shave November. By the way, come over here, please. No Shave November is the little college tradition that we have. She's not actually taller than me. I'm scooching down to try to get in the frame. Get in the shot. You may have to scooch down a bit, too. Sorry. No Shave November has already started. I'm getting a little bit of a delay. I'll let it go a day later as well. If I'm getting a day late as a start, I'll go a day late. Okay. She gives me the glare.
No.
Not such a fan of the beard. Not such a fan of the mustache. Mustache more so?
Mustache more so.
So I'm Jesus. Haha. And this is Little Red Riding Hood, but evil?
Dark. Yeah.
Little Maleficent Riding Hood? Alright. First of all. Alright. Second of all.
I don't have
all,
the basket with me. But
I actually do have something we're up to. Yeah, I should have gotten that from work. Should have asked them if they let us borrow it. Alright. Second thing. Magic game. Of course, you know me. Let's see if I can not mess this up. Alright. There we are. Something like that. That's good. Before we get started, here you are. Be very careful over the pre-release poster that we just turned a little bit.
Sorry.
I think that might have been my robe that did that.
No, that was my belly.
It was your belly?
Yeah.
Alright. Well, it's okay. It happens. Alright.
Pregnant lady belly.
But not just any match of magic. We are not doing what you would expect, white versus black over here. We are not doing the forces of good versus evil, although that would make sense. Actually, instead, we are going to be doing unmagic, as you can see in the title. Unhinged. No, not unhinged. Unglued. We'll be getting to unhinged in a bit. Okay. We were supposed to do this over at Dragonstar. One of her cards, we're going to pretend that it works, because we're going to pretend that we're over at Dragonstar for the purposes of that card being played. And you know exactly what it is if you played on... If you played on anything with a girl, or you are a girl having played it, you know what I'm talking about.
Yep.
Wait, what does being a girl matter? Oh yeah, you want to cut?
Yep.
What does being a girl matter? You'll see. You'll see. Maybe, if it comes up.
Hopefully it'll come up.
Hopefully
fingers crossed.
Alright, and here we are. No sideboards, we're just going to play 2 out of 3. Best to you, hon.
Okie dokie, who goes first?
Where did my rock, paper, scissors?
1, 2, 3.
Pick one.
4, 5, 6, 7.
Crap. Alright, let's see how it falls over. Well, I got rocks, so. And then there's paper. Alright. So, I do have one proxy, actually. Might as well show what it is. It's double play. We scoured the boxes looking for more of these, but since we didn't find them, I am playing proxies. If you see one that doesn't have a back that I'm playing, it's this. It's this. Is that cool?
Yeah, you might have to remind me of what the text is.
Okay. It's like a rampant growth, except much more expensive, and actually makes one come into play at the beginning of the next game between the two of us. Yeah, the next game. It's kind of like a ley line, but for the next game.
Wow.
Yeah. Fun cards. Un was weird. Un was very weird. Okay. And of course, we're running something silly because it's Un. This is Tribal Sheep versus Tribal Chickens. What's wrong?
Okay, if you saw any of the videos from yesterday, you did not see what I had.
By yesterday, she means Fallen Empires drafting.
Yes, but I got the exact same type of hand that I started out with yesterday, and I can't keep it.
Maybe you can.
No, I'm gonna go ahead and show everyone, including you, because it's quite funny.
Honestly, in this deck, I might have actually kept that, but... No, I think I would have kept that. I really do. Mull to 7. Free mulligan, but do hurry about it if you don't mind. Yeah. While I show off what the camera what I'm doing, which is not what I'm supposed to be doing. So remember, this is that. 1, 2... I'm going to say this out loud so that she knows exactly what's going on.
Yeah, Unhinged is before me, so I'm still...
This will make a little bit of sense later. A little bit. Just a touch, but yeah. 2 of... this card. Or I could have just overlaid it on the screen, whatever.
Well, that's great for next game. Here we go.
Where did my dice bag run off to?
Right there.
You're good. That's the cut.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I just realized. Our dice bag has a friend's D6 in it. We need to give that over to him at some point.
Okay.
It's Joe's. Guy that beat me, I think it's Joe's. Guy that beat me in the finals of our drafting.
I'll keep it.
And you mulled to 7, did you?
Yep.
Alright. I will go. I'll start off with... da-da-da-da! A forest. That's it. Pass. Easy enough. You know, we really should have done a white versus black drafting for this. Unfortunately, my friend Doug, who cosplayed as Darth Satan, apparently... Darth Blanket. It's just a lightsaber and a blanket, but he had devil horns.
Your turn.
It could have worked for him to do this. Indeed.
Yeah, I gotta love that red
Pass
lightsaber.
Turn.
At the end of your turn, I'm gonna tap to go and find a basic land.
Alright. That'll do.
And yes, I know it comes into staff, but tap.
The draw? Okay. Well, maybe it's end of turn. Who cares?
The beginning of my turn?
I sure. Think. Shenanigans.
Yeah.
Weird card is weird.
I'll play red.
Okay.
Oh no, I'm sorry.
I gotcha. It's, Kurigan, I think? Alright.
Chicken egg!
During your upkeep, and this is why I pulled out the D6, we roll a D6. It's a 0-1 until you hit a 6. Yes, on a 6, sacrifice and becomes a 4-4 giant chicken token. Yeah. Okay, that's turn?
Mm-hmm, your turn.
Okay. Aha!
3 green.
But still, pass turn. This is nuts.
My guess is you're not getting your correct colors.
I can neither confirm nor deny.
Oh, I'm supposed to roll. I forgot to roll my D6.
I was gonna roll it, but it's yours. Okay, well, a 2 will not do it. We'll keep that there. Or upkeep, we'll keep it on the,
okay.
On the Konichi's booty. So check this out. I'm gonna borrow this for a second. I form a picture. These are the first sleeves that she and I ever got together. And so that's sentimental to us. Could swing at me with a 0-1.
Yeah, that's not gonna help me much.
True, true. Well, these sleeves... Jeez. Team Spirit. That's an instant, honey.
Oh, sorry.
Are you doing that to make it a 1-2 until end of turn?
Yes. End of swing.
I take 1 point of damage. That's un for ya. Alright, pass turn?
Yes. I gotta start doing this.
Sure, sure. Alright, now, conundrum time. When Bronze Calendar comes into play, actually, let me just read his text to you. Your spells cost one less to play as long as you speak in a voice other than your normal voice. If you speak in your normal voice, you have to sacrifice this.
Dang it.
Now, I do have a radio show that I do on weekends. I can do a number of voices, but here's the trick as far as I'm concerned. What do I do? Do I do the stereo? No. English. It's a requirement to be an American voice actor. You have to do an English accent. That's not anything. I could try to do... Yeah, which one? Thank you. I do have that French voice, but no one seems to understand that. Maybe it's too thick. Is that the problem?
Yeah.
It's not actually French. It just sounds... To a lot of Americans, it sounds French.
But whatever. The problem is that nobody will be able to understand anything that I'm saying the whole time that I'm doing this.
Oh, I love that unvoiced TH. But I could just do Scottish. How's that sound? That way if you get something like this, we could do Scottish. The Scottish mirror, right?
Okay.
Alright then, so for the rest of this, I'll have to do a bad Scottish accent. I'll have to try to anyway. Pass turn. Also, all my spells are gonna cost one less. That's fun enough.
Which helps one? Very much.
Look, the thing's
gods!
Well, that's a thing. That means you turn it to a fair-fed chicken.
I'm just gonna turn it over.
Alright then. Gonna turn it around so that she's actually facing me. Now it says as long as I speak in a voice other than my normal voice.
So I thought you were doing all the silly verses, but apparently this one's annoying too, isn't it?
She's doing this right there. Alright then. Well... Sorry, I didn't mean to do this to you. You didn't ask for it. Apologies. Well, that tells you how terrible I am at this. Yeah, well, whatever. Let's see what we do.
Just because I think it would be really, really funny.
Alright then.
Terramorphic Expanse, I'm going to go ahead and tap it.
Alright, what would you like?
Another Plains.
Alright then. Oh gods, I know what she's going to play. But yeah, this will be funny. We'll have to turn the camera up a little bit. Tribal Chicken from Unglued, what do you think she's about to play? A boot? It looks in that a boot. No, you do know it comes intact.
Yeah.
So you can't use it this turn.
Yeah, I know.
Alright then. Well, turn it so the pretty seeds up. Alright then, that's it.
Your turn.
Alright.
Well,
Let's swing
first,
Jim. Alright, so you have me now at 15.
Woo!
Let's see what we got. Alright then. Well, let's start off by playing one of my double plays. So it's this card right up here. I'm gonna go and search for a land. Let's see, does the land have to come in top? Put that land into play. It does not say that it comes in top. Alright. So let's see, is it on the top? It is not on the top. Alright then, we'll just go through and find one.
Going to,
Yeah, go ahead, read it as much as you like. It's gonna be nice and thin for you coming up. Well, there you go. And then I'm going to set down what's called a Jack-in-the-Mox. Whenever I want to tap it, I have to roll a d6. I'm not really using to get this one out, the one that's right there. And if I roll a 1, I have to. Excuse me about that. I'll have to sacrifice it. On any other number, it gives me a separate color of mana. So, nice and fun. I don't get really any control over it, but I'm a mono-color deck, but so as far as I'm concerned, that's just colorless. Alright then, I still have a 1 in 6 chance of doing save to myself. And I'm going to say, that's the turn. Alright, well, we know what she's about to do. This is going to be nice and fun. We're going to get a lot of this. I should do.
Well, first.
Alright, Poultrygeist. Alright, so this is a 1-1. Whenever a creature is put onto any graveyard from play, you may roll a d6. On a 1, you sack it, otherwise you put a 1-1 on it. Mesa Chicken. You have to, in order to give it flying until end of turn, you have to, what are you doing it now? You don't have to, oh, okay, I thought you were going to adjust it. In order to give it flying, you have to stand up, flap your arms, and cluck like a chicken. And if I had to do that, I'd have to do it in a Scottish accent. Alright, so would you like to swing off me?
Yes, yes I would.
You have me down to 11.
I'll put this up here.
Sure. And that's 10?
Yep.
Alright then, let's see what we've got. How long? Let's see, if you were to swing with the whole team at me, that would put me down to... Yeah, I don't like that at all. I don't think I have too much of a choice then. I don't know how to do it, don't I? Alright then, well...
What really stinks about him having to do an accent other than his own is he can switch between his accents as long as it's not his normal one.
Well, you don't mind if I do that, right? Is that... that's perfectly alright? So I'm going to be tapping this for 6. And then I'm going to tap Jack-in-the-Mox. That's why I'd rather keep doing this one. Alright, anything but the 1. Okay, it's a 4. 4 says that I've got black mana floating in the pool.
Okay.
Alright, well then. In that case, let's see. 23. I'm going to cast a Flock of Rabid Sheep. X equals 6. And so now...
So you've got 6 1-1s?
I have 6. Now, it says sheep, but I'm going to do paper tiger. Because sheep, whatever. Who cares if it's a treble deck? I'm just going to do this.
And it's not a 6-6, it's
8. It's
6-1-1s.
2-2. Yeah, it says they're 2-2s.
That's broken.
Let's share, eh? And, yeah, that's my turn. So all you've got to deal with is 6 of these suckers.
All I have to deal with.
Sure. You can do that. Hey, you may want to untap the last creature of yours.
Yeah.
Alright, well, she's got another favorite of colors.
So do you want to,
Yes, let's do this. Alright then. Well. Stand in the center. Alright. We can see now. Alright, I think that qualifies. Your Mesa Chicken now has flying. I think
get
that,
used to that
definitely
because...
qualifies. when we have little Evangeline, I'm sure that'll be a way to make her happy. Alright then, well. So that one's flying now. And what else would you like to do? And the thing is... Well then, I'm going to end up... Oh, swinging... This is going to go down to 3. No, no it's not. It's going to go to 4. Because 2 of them are going to double block your 4-4.
Okay.
And then one of them will...
You can't. It's flying.
Oh, it does have flying. It has it on its own, doesn't it? Well, never mind then. Sorry about that. Well,
and technically that doesn't go off because this was a token. It was not the
sacrifice.
Well,
no, it still goes to the graveyard.
Well...
It still goes to the graveyard. So, take it. Roll to see what we've got.
Okay.
fave. Alright, so it gets a 1-1 counter. Right then, Lot's turn?
Yep, your turn.
Alright. Well, let's see what happens to me now. Definitely playing another Jack-in-the-Mox. Because why the hell not? Let's see. Of the potential for 8 damage, or yeah, 8 damage right here. Yeah, good grief.
It's whether you can come in before I can kill you.
Well, tell me about it. Let's see, if I were to do this. Oh, that's so risky. I don't know if I want to. The chances... See, the problem here, let me show you what I've got. I've got two of these, which are counting as double play, which I mentioned from before. I didn't mind telling her this now. So the trick is, if I want to, I can easily cast one. I can, and that's what I'm going to do, actually. I'm going to cast one of them. Well, actually, let's do this. Let's do this instead. Double play, which is costing one cheaper off of the bronze calendar. It does not say that it has to come in tapped. So it comes in untapped. Yeah, check it out. That's a... It's not exactly powerful, but this is unglued, so it's whatever it wants to be.
That is stupid.
Tell me, dude, do you want a cut? No.
I play Terramorphic Expanse, and all of everything has to come into play tapped with that.
That's what I want to do. I'll say that way. We're going to swing 8 at you.
Okay.
See if we can deal you enough damage there. Put you down to 12. Alright. You know what? There's actually not really a need for me to not. Oh, yeah, don't draw quite yet. There's not a need for me to do this. It doesn't give me much of an advantage at all, except maybe in the next game. So instead, I'm just going to say, you know what? I pass my turn. I do wish I had a sheep token. The store owner back at Dragonstar, one of the other reasons to do it up there, is that he does have sheep tokens. Well, he has one, we put a day over it. And that's what we've got to do. If we want to have it realistically. Oh, realistically. I mean, with the actual token. Instead of paper tiger. Yeah, because these things are a little more brutal than a sheep, in my opinion. I mean, a human is a 1-1. A sheep is a 2-2? Well, okay. I guess I can see that. Yeah, what are we casting here? Another chicken. No. Free-range chicken. Free-range chicken. Roll two, let's see what is it. Roll two six-sided dice. If both come out the same, it gets plus X, where X is whatever that roll is. Then, if you do that more than once, and you get a roll with the same total as the one you got before, you have to sacrifice it. So that's nice and easy to remember. Oh, you're doing it! You're doing it! Alright, do you want me to do it this time? For you?
Sure.
Alright. Get out of the way, I've got to do this. You get to see Jesus being clucking like a chicken. Right. Enough of that. Let's get back to the game. Right, so now it has flying. Right then, well.
A flying chicken. Something I've never seen before.
Something you've never come across before. Right then, well. And that puts me down to 4.
Mm-hmm.
See if we can do this. And I actually didn't think it's possible. Let's see. If I get through with that. 6. Oh, it is possible. But it's not going to happen. It's not going to happen. But it's possible. Let's see. I'm going to cast another double play. Get another one. So that when the next game starts, I'll have 3.
3.
I'll have 3 lands already in play. So that'll make it nice and fun on you. I get a head start. Even if I lose this one, I may have it. Alright then, well, here we go. See what you got. I'm going to swing the 4/2/2 sheep tokens at you.
I'm going to block one of said sheep tokens.
Alright, here we go. You want to see something nice and fun? Unless I roll a 6, I don't win. What I'm doing, I'm going to pump one of the ones that is not being blocked by the free-range chicken. You're about to take 6 damage no matter what, because you've got 3 2/2s swinging at you.
Yep.
One of them will get plus X, where X is whatever I roll on this die. No pressure there. I have to have a 6 or else I lose. Alright, well, you got this game.
Yay!
Because you'll just kill me on the swing back. Well, let's try that again. 2 fail plays. I'm just going to keep these 3 out, actually. You understand why. Yeah, I think it was made bad moving it. Okay, so I can stop doing that now. Game's over. So that's how this deck is supposed to run, except for the losing part. Except for that. That's
hey
how it's
now.
Supposed to do its thing.
What about this deck?
That's how your deck's supposed to run. Get a bunch of chickens. Now, you may be wondering, especially if you've cheated and already looked in the description, why is Chicken a la King not in this deck? It's a one-card infinite combo. That's why. If you notice, a lot of cards nowadays say tap an untapped or tap 3 untapped creatures that you control. Heritage Druid is the first one that comes to mind for me. And the reason that they say that is because if they didn't, technically you can force a tap effect on an already tapped creature. It just wouldn't do anything. Chicken a la King. Tap a chicken you can... Isn't it tap a chicken you control? I think that's right. Well, so that... And then you put counters on it. So, tap this creature with that a trigger on the stack, or with that ability on the stack. Tap it again, so on and so forth. It's not part of the cost. At least if I remember that card correctly. That's why. And I'm pretty sure that I remember that correctly. Of course, it's also unmagic, so who cares, right? Who really cares how that card's supposed to be played? Eh. Alright. So, going in with a huge advantage.
Yeah. Mop. Yeah. 3 lands.
3 lands. Here we go. Let's try this
Finger.
Again. There you go.
It's an example of winning a battle but losing the war.
Well, I don't know. We are going to 3, so maybe you'll still have the war. I believe the term is Pyrrhic victory? Pyrrhic victory? If I have another victory like this, I may come home alone. Quote was something like that. Alright. There we are. Draw your 7.
I'm assuming you're going first since you...
Oh, yes.
Even though you have huge card advantage.
Huge card advantage. Well, this is a weird hand, but I'll do it. Alright, I'm keeping. What do you say?
I'll keep. Just give me a moment.
Okay.
Okay.
You keeping? Now, as far as I'm concerned, doing a southern accent is a foreign accent to me, because even though I'm from the south, I don't do this all that much. This is gonna be so fun. You have to listen to me talk like Bubba from back home.
You sound like Forrest Gump.
I do.
You sound like me.
I'm gonna do this the whole time. I apologize, YouTube. I do.
I'm gonna go ahead and sack it.
Sure thing.
I mean, you guys already know what the heck I'm playing, so there's no point in me.
You mind if I take my turn then? Since it's gonna come in tapped.
Tapped.
Since it's gonna come in tapped. Let's see, what do we want to do here? Here. Let's put out another bronze calendar. Doesn't mean I have to do 2 different weird accents at once. That would be kind of impossible, I think.
You could do a British cowboy. No, I don't
I'm
know
I'm trying to
either.
Imagine what a British cowboy would sound like. That guy from Shanghai Nights. Something like
no,
that.
No, because he's not British.
And then I'm going to pass the turn over to you, young lady. Alright. So if she went for a mountain, maybe that means that she's got herself a... chicken egg. That's what it is. Chicken egg. Chicken egg time. Alright, I'm gonna get out my D6. Make sure we don't forget this. Is this not the most annoying voice you've ever heard in your entire life? Oh my god, no! No. That's not. See, I can't even. This is officially the most annoying voice to me. It's so.
Sacrifice both of them, or just one?
If I go back to my normal voice, then yeah, I do.
You got very close there.
I got very close. Which means I should probably pick another accent, one that doesn't annoy me so much. That almost messed it up.
Your turn.
Or I could just stop talking.
Yeah, that's not gonna happen. You have to narrate. You suck. You suck. Suck, 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 suck. Suck. Where is something I can throw at you? Something soft that's not gonna hurt. I don't like you. Ow! That actually hurt. My turn. So he's gone to not talking. You do realize you have to talk. I don't like you. What do you mean?
You want to see how to make her laugh? But...
I am not going to laugh because you're being a meanie pie.
But...
Nope, you're being mean.
Right, fine, then I'll just talk like this then. How's that
okay.
Sound? This is something we can live with.
Yes.
Right then. It's easy enough.
And I'm also... Wait.
I've got an idea! I'll just be Mickey the whole time!
I'll flip the countertop.
You will not! It's actually attached to the ground!
I will find a way to flip the countertop.
You can follow everything up with. It makes it all the better! It's my turn! You get over here!
Oh,
get over here, huh?
My hips are hurting.
Wish we had a chair we could pull up right there!
Yeah.
Oh!
Please stop.
No!
Please
stop. Oh no!
I've got a headache.
You totally asked for this, not really! The swing throw at you! Do you want a block?
No, I'll take it.
Alright, then! Team Spirit! Instead of 12, I'm swinging 18!
Okay.
And then! Growth Spurt! Roll it! If I get a 2 or higher, I win!
Please stop, that really does hurt my head. There you go.
So now that I win... Yeah.
Yeah, but see, now he starts the next game without that land.
That crazy advantage right off the top. Yes, that's true.
I wasn't going to give him any extra time to be able to get that.
I considered stalling a little bit so that... I have time to try to build it up again. But it basically restarts the whole match, except you go first this time.
Yep.
So now we don't have to worry about Mickey the... We had a name for him on the show, which we will not say here.
I'm sorry, I've been up since 7 o'clock this morning for no good reason. Yeah. It's only like 10:20 right now where we are at night, and I shouldn't be this tired.
Let's flip those back around. Oh, wait a minute. That totally works in this deck. It is an untournament, so I guess you could actually put them in, couldn't you?
Probably.
Yeah. We should do that.
No. No, we should not.
We should not, you think?
No.
Oh yeah, I tossed them over at you. That's why they're over there. Something soft that won't hurt.
And it still ended up hurting.
Playing cards. Oh.
I think it was more because I wasn't expecting them.
Cutting me?
No, I'm not gonna cut you.
Cutting my deck? Okay.
Okay. I will go first, by the way.
Sure, sure. Flipping the screen back around.
Okay. Probably shouldn't, but I'm going to anyway because there's a card in here that I've been wanting to play that I haven't been able to yet.
Okay.
Okay.
You're up. It's a wonderful place to live.
Terramorphic Expanse, go fetch.
Well, Evolving Wilds, but close enough.
Does the same exact thing.
Yep. Functional reprints for the win. Pass turn. So it might as well come in untapped. Oh. Poultrygeist, maybe? We'll see. Tribal chickens may win. I'm not feeling very confident about this.
That makes me feel better, because I wasn't feeling very confident either.
Okay, that makes me feel... not more confident, less unsure.
Your turn.
Okay.
That's why I'm not feeling more confident.
Your turn. Land, go, land, go.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, your turn.
Uh-oh. Oh boy.
Didn't think I would have this much problem with the land.
Discard a double play? Go.
Yep.
It's gonna be one of those games. Uh-oh. She found her land.
What color do I want?
I'm guessing red or green, if I had to guess.
Yep, you would be correct.
Red or green? Red? Red, okay.
Your turn.
Jack-in-the-Mox. It's kind of hitting my land. Kind of.
Do you want to cut my deck?
Poke. Pass turn. Oh boy. Alright.
Rakdos chicken.
We may have a clock going on, maybe. Let's turn.
Yep. Where did D6 go?
Set it right behind me.
I think I'll put one right here, that way I can...
Pass turn. Yeah, that's not me casting it, I'm afraid.
Thank God you don't have to live with me sounding like this the whole time.
Yeah, I'll probably shoot you.
Ah!
Whoo! Wait.
Lucky kitty! Lucky kitty is now your chicken.
Okay. I'm putting that next to her, that way I can...
Okay.
Okay, she's a 4-4.
Swinging at me?
I have not drawn yet.
Okay, that's true.
Go fetch for land.
Come on, Deck, find me some lands. Could really use some.
Yeah, I know that feeling.
Poke. Cutting your deck.
Thank you.
Nice and easy. It all just depends on you, Deck. Poultrygeist. Okay. Have me to 16.
So I'll turn it this way.
Sure. They can see it.
Yeah, cute. Jay got this for me, not last Christmas, but the Christmas before.
Pastor?
Yeah.
Yeah. Land screw will do it. I have the main I have the one card combo.
You weren't
going
to.
No, it's not a one card combo. No, I don't have enough mana to cast my double play.
I see that.
Three of them in the yard, though. I guess it's possible that I could start coming back, but... Whew! That would be a trick. Mesa Chicken, yes! You have me at 11.
Your turn.
Come on, Deck! Okay, we're kind of in business. How do I want to do this?
By not playing a single thing.
That's not going to happen.
I kind of like that you have the three of those in your graveyard right now.
Let's see. Yeah, I don't think I have much of a choice. Let's roll it! A 2, okay, that's fine. Flock of Rabid Sheep, I have 2 2-2s out.
Okay.
Pass turn.
Where are you at, your 11?
I'm at 11. Look at this hand. What is going on here? Oh dear, a late start is all. The deck has quite a few lands. I'm tempted to say, if you count the Moxen, it's 22. But they're just not showing up this game. Oh dear, another Poultrygeist. Yeah, being of my nightmares.
We're gonna pretend this is the one
that just came into play. I mean, that did not just come into play. Okay, so I'll block... these two rabbit sheep will block your 4-4 and trade. Alright, it's time to do this. I need
a
1.
So do I roll 3 times?
For each, yes.
Oh, so I roll 6 times?
Yes. And a 1 in any case. We count these for the first one, so that's a counter. That's a counter. Oh! Dang, okay then. Well, 3 on you.
Oh, well, yeah, we'll use that one. I'm not coming back from that. 2. That's a counter. 5. 2. Ooh. Okay, then. So, you have 2 4-4s out with flying. Yeah, so I lose here.
Well, you know what? If we're going to go out...
may as well go out swinging.
Might as well.
I'm proud of myself for that.
Sure.
I have very bad luck most of the time.
So here's my hand. Bronze calendar, bronze calendar, bronze calendar. Team spirit, team spirit, team spirit. So you know what I'm going to do. You have no idea what I'm going to do. I'm going to cast a bronze calendar.
Pick something.
Whichever one you want.
Someone out there will get that if they watch like Yu-Gi-Oh! Abridged. Oh wait, I stopped using it! Now it's gone! Ah! And then I will roll. Get a one. 5. Okay, well never mind then. Yeah, I was hoping I could kill myself, or... No, I couldn't kill myself. I couldn't... 5 damage isn't enough, but... That's 10 coming my way. In all seriousness, bronze calendar, and then I wait. You put me down to 1, and unless you have a team spirit. Do you have a team spirit in hand? Actually, do you have a forest as well? No. Okay, well then you couldn't kill me this turn, and then I draw, get a double play, and then cast the double play, and start the next game with 1 land against you.
It's been three games, so.
Yeah, it's been 3. So we'll just remember this. The next time that you and I play, sex appeal! There we go.
It didn't come on.
It did not come on. Or come up, rather. Whatever.
That's why I kept
prevent 3 damage to, or total to any number of creatures and or players. But if there are more players in the room of the opposite sex, which is why we treat this place as Dragonstar Hobbies, the local game store, prevent up to 3 additional damage to any number of creatures and or players.
Which is the reason why I was playing chickens instead of sheep. One of the reasons.
We would have to just throw in some planes for no reason other than you doing that.
Hey, I won on camera.
You did. You won.
This is the first time I've done that.
Yeah. It happens. That's one of the beautiful things about trading card games like this. Look, 4 double plays and not enough lands. If you lose, it is possible, you shouldn't do this too much, but it is possible to say, I lost because of luck. The deck screwed me. And that's perfectly fine. I think that's a good thing. Mm-hmm. That way you don't get too... It's not like chess. You get frustrated at your lack of skill, and that makes it where you don't want to keep working at it until you have enough skill to keep winning. Oh. For a lot of chess players, that is the case.
Me.
For you? Ah. For me, it was... Frankly, I just didn't have people with whom to play chess for a bit. Even my dad wouldn't, for a while. And so I just got rusty at it, and yeah. Oh, that's it. Well, never mind then.
My dad always loved playing chess with me, but my dad would always like to play chess with me, but he was of the mindset that even when you're very, very little, you don't let them win. You might go easier on them than you normally would, but you make them work for it.
Mm.
And in chess, I was never very good. I always lost at chess.
This is why I did that with the double play. I was actually going to go in with a card that is not all that useful in this matchup. Growth Spurt. 3 Growth Spurts and just insert random card here. Valor and Outlander. See it in my zoo deck every now and then, against mono-black control. Yeah, this does me no good until I already have the sheep out. I'd rather be able to ramp. Not only can I start the game with more lands and do what I did to you, that ugliness, but it just gives me more sheep in that game. So that's how tribal sheep is supposed to go. Oh well. Alright, YouTube?
Thank you for watching this completely random video. This is kind of what I imagined the Halloween special would be, except I had hoped this would be drunk magic. Maybe next time we will. We will have no proxies, hopefully, and we'll have plenty of alcohol, and we'll do that. It'll be our Christmas special, right? Once you're no longer preggers, or maybe not you, maybe it'll be someone else. Alright. Oh yeah, by the way, we're having a kid. Nice and fun.
5 weeks.
5 weeks.
Five weeks
short
and
weeks.
2 days till the due date.
Oh my goodness.
With his luck.
Yes, please. We're still in school. We'll have one semester with a baby at the same time.
You'll have more than that.
You'll have more than that, that's true. But by the time that you, by the time that I get done, it's only 6 months from now, so, you know, I can take over more of those duties. And you'll still be doing online courses. Make it nice and easy, relatively speaking. I guess it's never really easy, but relatively speaking. All right, I will see you in the next video.
Bye-bye!
Bye-bye!